But I've got a friend who's a massive bumper car. It's amazing we get on. Our lifestyles are so totally, totally different. We were having a general chat about how you meet potential partners. And I said, because I like to get to know people a little bit first, I said, I don't think I've ever kissed a man about whom I didn't know his GCSE results. You may mock, but it's a very good way of filtering out all of the over 40s with their fucking O-levels. My friend said, is that true? And I said, yeah. And he said, oh my God. He said, I've had sex with people I haven't even seen. Well, my friend has what I think is a dangerous lifestyle. He thinks it's exciting, but I think it's dangerous. For me, exciting's when you start a new tea towel. I love it. It's been in the cupboard. It's all clean. It's got no bean juice on it. Fucking love it. But my friend's lifestyle is dangerous. He takes drugs on a regular basis. I drink 3 pints of shandy a year. I can't even drink properly, let alone take drugs. Gives it to you if you've never taken drugs in your life. There's loads of us. See, my friend was telling me about this proper night that he'd had. He was listing all of these drugs. And I didn't know anything about drugs, but I was pretending to look cool. And as he was listing them, I was going, uh-huh. 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 Oh, that one's smashing. The reason I don't know anything about drugs is because Zamo said, say no. It's a very age-specific joke, that one. It's a lot of people under 30 going, who the fuck is Zamo? Google him, you might learn something. So my friend's story is getting increasingly more boastful, and I had a horrible feeling that I was going to have to match it at the end with a similar story. And he ended his story by saying, oh my God, my friends were texting me the next day saying, you've got no idea what shit you got up to last night. It was brilliant. And then he went like this. Like it was my turn. I was thinking, what on earth am I going to say? So I had to think and I went, sometimes, oh fuck. Sometimes I eat strepsils when I've run out of sweets. I'm not proud. But then my friend starts telling me about his sexual exploits and he said he'd had sex on a kitchen sink. He said, have you ever had sex on a kitchen sink? And I wanted to tell him that I thought it sounded incredibly unhygienic. But I didn't, I just went, no. And I got home and I thought, am I a prude? I don't think I am a prude, but maybe I am. So I said to my boyfriend, would you like to have sex on a kitchen sink? I get the impression it's supposed to be a bit more in the moment, you know, rather than like when you've done those dishes, get your arse on there. Because we're very well matched, my boyfriend said, why would I want to have sex on a kitchen sink? That'd be like eating your dinner out of a shoe. Then my friend said he's had sex on a plane. He said, have you ever had sex on a plane? I said, I've not had sex on a sink and that's in me flat. What do you reckon? And he said, I've had sex on a plane. He said, that's dangerous, that's exciting. I said, well, I suppose it is. But I think having a massive shit with a queue outside on a plane is more dangerous. And I've definitely done that. And from the clapping, I can tell I'm not the only one. We're all members of the Pile High Club.
Hello, it's Sarah Millican here. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Don't forget to like, pop a comment below, and why not stick around to watch a few more? I'm sure those emails or those dishes can wait a bit longer.